Well, welcome back. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about abstract art and how to make sense of it. When I was originally thinking about this blog, I was originally going to talk about the process that I go through to choose what my next piece of art is going to be. But in the planning of that, it became apparent to me that I needed to discuss abstract art versus non-abstract art. And the reason was I'd had several conversations just recently, either about my art or about abstract. And it was important just to talk this through. So in one conversation, a fellow artist had declared that he didn't understand abstracts, he couldn't do them, and he couldn't see them. And my response to that, it's all about getting people to actually look, to really look at the piece of art in front of them. When you look at an abstract, your brain doesn't really know what to expect, so you have to look at it and then make some kind of response to it. You have to use your eyes and your brain. It was in fact the same artist who said he went back to see Berenice a couple of times because he liked it so much, and that is abstracted as well. So that's very interesting to see that. Another artist, when I showed him one of my pieces of true abstract art, said it was, and I'm quoting here, the most mathematically beautiful thing he had ever seen. He loved it. He saw it. He said, wow. And it's actually very hard to get an abstract right. I dismiss or discard many, many different forms. And it takes quite a while, and it's quite exacting. What I do is quite exacting. So when I commit it to the canvas, I've gone through quite a long process to get there. And it has to be committed to the canvas exactly. And then the beadwork has to be done exactly and committed to the canvas as well. And that includes the organic pieces. And some artists have told me that they find it quite difficult to do abstracts. They don't know how to place the lines or the colours. It just doesn't work for them no matter what they do. And the point is that it's much harder to do an abstract than many people realise. One slip of the paintbrush and the piece can be ruined. Whereas within conventional artworks, you might be able to get away with a slip in a landscape or a rose or whatever. On top of that, abstracts are quite challenging for the viewer. They're not sure what they're looking at. It's not obviously a horse or an animal or a sunset or a landscape or whatever. It's much more about being suggestive, evocative, being a concept, being a feeling. It's good for people to be able to free their minds and actually see within the piece a little bit more. There's something unconventional about it, which I like. For me personally, I also like to bring joy and an uplifting experience in the pieces of work or in the video that I make, whatever it happens to be. So the colours are strong and vibrant, it's got motion, it flows, and it's positive. And whilst a lot of it is meditative, it's also energising and meditative. When you look at it, that experience that you get from it. So the beads work for me because they're like my paint. They add the colours, the vibrancy, they're really, really effective. So they bring vibrancy and calmness together, since everything is arranged in a nice pattern and it just is perfect, absolutely perfect. It's very difficult to show that on screen, but it does look like that when you've got it in front of you in a nice light. So the next time you are approaching an abstract and you're inclined to dismiss it and walk away, take a moment, remove the obstacles from your mind and stop for a moment and linger at that piece. And I'm sure you will enjoy it. And it's only that way that you'll be able to decipher or discern the good from the bad. So I hope you've enjoyed that. So please subscribe. Next time I'm going to talk a little bit about the next pieces that I'm going to be doing. So same time, same place. See you there.